2019 Mercedes-Benz G-Class introduced in Detroit at the Detroit Auto Show. We got a chance to sit down with Ola Källenius, the head of Mercedes Research and Development. The 48-year-old Swede, who was previously head of AMG and Mercedes Alabama manufacturing facility, discussed a wide range of Benz-related topics on the 2019 Mercedes-Benz G-Class introduced in Detroit, and how you make it better on-road without sacrificing its off-road capability. This was the task to the engineering team: why is the G legendary? Because the G is the go-everywhere car. So we must make sure that in terms of off-road performance it really is the pinnacle of SUVs. And when we do the Schöckl run, the Austrian off-road answer to the Nürburgring, the new car is better up the Schöckl run than the old one. At the same time, needless to say, for the on-road performance, an independent front suspension is preferable. So they were given that Gordian knot, and I think that sword, and cut through that knot. Once you get to drive the new car on the road, you'll see you have a hugely improved drive on the road combined with the new steering, as well, that makes a world of difference. So I think we have done both. Taken an off-road icon to the next level and have a car that's on-road performance is also very capable. On the G-Class styling and packaging. Another crucial point with the G is don't mess with the styling. The G is a G and it needs to stay a G. But if you put the two cars next to each other, you'll see the new car is 100mm wider and also longer. When I now step into the car, and I'm 6'4.5", I now have a very comfortable seating position and at the same time, someone can sit behind me. That was another one of those areas where we felt that, while we're at it, let's make sure the interior packaging is also taken to the next level. You also have a dedicated G-only interior, so everything was developed in one go. On the Mercedes-AMG 53 models also introduced in Detroit and the reaction of existing AMG customers to new, entry-level models. The feedback has been overwhelmingly positive. I can remember myself, when I was at AMG, and we launched the A45. It was a bit of a revolution. I received similar questions from journalists about, what is the S63 or E63 customer going to say about the A45? And of course we spoke to numerous customers and showed them the concept before we went to market, and without exception, the reaction was cool. You have to be authentic in every segment. If you're an E63 customer, maybe an A45 is something you buy for your son or for your daughter, or maybe you just buy it for yourself as a fun car. It needs to be authentic. Every segment where we have broadened the portfolio of AMG, we have made sure it is 100% AMG. The same can be said for the introduction of the entry-level production models, so the 43s and now the 53s. The customers that go for the 63, the very top-range performance car, they have the best that you can get. But they don't mind that there's a segment between the regular series car and the full Monty, if you will, that offers an entry point into the AMG family. It's almost as if 63 is a brand within a brand.